Last episode, I talked about Python's DBM, a quick and dirty way to stash keys and values to disk. Today, I'm looking at another Python standard library goodie in the same vein. It's called shelve, and it lets you persist entire Python objects to disk. Shelve works by taking a Python object and serializing it into a binary form using Python's pickle library. This binary can then be written to disk and then read back into memory, allowing the original object to be reconstructed. Now, not all Python objects can be pickled, and so not all Python objects can be stored with shelve. We'll go into details about that in a bit. But the vast majority of what you're going to use day-to-day can be stored in this fashion. So let's take a look at some examples. Using shelve works almost exactly like using a cross between a file and a dictionary. In this example here, I create a shelve object on disk named data, and in it I store a key named schema with the integer value 1. Notice I'm using with to create a context manager, again, much as I would if I was reading or writing to a file. This ensures the objects get synchronized out to disk once we leave the context block. Now we can do a lot more than just store simple objects like dictionaries and strings and numbers. We can also store complex objects like class instances, but again, there are some restrictions. So in this module, I have defined a simple class named user. And over in my main program, I'm going to import that class, create an instance of it, and save that instance into the shelve file. Now when I want to read these objects back from disk, I can do the opposite. I can open the shelve data file as before, and then read from the keys into variables. So if I run this, you're going to see that we have our retrieved object information printed to the console, both our integer and our reconstructed class instance. Now with classes, there's a subtle wrinkle here. When an object like a class instance or a function is shelved, Python uses the object's fully qualified name in your program to store where to find its definition for the sake of reconstructing it. When we read the object back out, Python looks up the same fully qualified name to figure out how to put it back together from the serialized data. Here's what I mean by this. If we store an instance of user, Python will note that it's an instance of an object definition that's found in the module user under the name user, user.user being the full path. Now, when we read back the same object somewhere else, Python will look up the definition for that object in our program by that same full path. So, for instance, in this module, we're reading back the user instance from shelve, but we haven't imported the user class anywhere. Shelve will figure out where it is based on its original location. So, we don't actually need to do the import at all. Python will simply perform the reconstruction on its own. Now the upshot of this is, if you're using shelve to store complex objects like classes, make sure the definitions for those objects are available in some module that everything else in the program can also reach. In other words, don't define these things in the same place where you're shelving them, unless that's the only place you're ever going to shelve them. For instance, if we had user defined here in this module, we would only be able to shelve and load user instances in that module and nowhere else. And one more thing is that the kinds of objects that you can store in shelve are limited to what can be pickled or serialized in Python. Anything you can't reconstruct from nothing but the Python definition of the object is probably not going to make it. For instance, here's an example where we have a C-types pointer. This refers to something outside the Python runtime, which may well be ephemeral. So in this example, I've got two C-types objects. One of them is an unsigned long, and the other is a pointer to that object. I can shelve the long value since it's just a value. I can reconstruct it easily. But a pointer to that value can't be preserved because that pointer only makes sense during the lifetime of the original object. Saving the pointer and then trying to restore it later won't point to anything. One last note, anything that you write to or read from a shelve file has no safeties. Nothing's going to stop you from writing sensitive data or reading untrusted code. So you only want to use shelve in circumstances where there are no security issues or where you have absolute control over what's saved and loaded. So to sum up, shelve lets you store and load Python objects in what amounts to a disk-backed dictionary. The definitions of those objects need to be available in order to reconstruct the objects when you load them. and the types of objects you can shelve are limited to what can be serialized using Python's pickle module. But almost every kind of object you use on a daily basis can be shelved. And finally, there's no security with shelved objects, so you use them at your own risk. And that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow David Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.